Greetings, Peter Nelson here with Full Service Property Management. And I will get prospective owners asking me, well, how much can you rent my property for? And my initial response is as much as we can get for. But the reality of it is that we have a method in place that allows us to get the most for your rental property without letting the property go stale. So I always tell owners that during a vacancy, it's not about cash, it's about cash flow. And leaving a vacant unit or a unit vacant for an extra 2 to 4 weeks, trying to chase an extra $50 or $100, simply does not make sense. So the process that we take to it is we, first of all, we do a comprehensive market analysis, a CMA, and we'll search the internet and we'll come up with a range of what we think is a good market price for that property. And I'm just going to make an example for this. Let's just say we think your property can rent for between $2,000 and $2,400. What we will do then is we will start usually at that $2,400. In many cases, we'll even start out at $2,500 just to make sure we don't get it wrong. And we'll start the marketing process. Now, like I said before, we're not going to let it sit there forever and ever trying to get that last little dollar with it. We monitor the amount of inquiries that we receive on a weekly basis for each property. And at the end of the week, we look to see how many there are. And the magic number I've learned is 6. If we can get 6 or more inquiries in a week, then usually we have found in our own experience that the chances of leasing that property go up dramatically. So we're looking for 6 to 12 vacancies, generally speaking. If we get fewer than 6, it's amazing how that drops off the cliff. 5 is really marginal, and 4 or fewer, and you're pretty much just marking time. So what we will do is we'll go out there and using that, going back to that example, let's just say we go out there at $2,500 and actually we use gasoline pricing. So it isn't $2,500, it's $2,495 because that just sounds cheaper than $2,500. So we go out there at $2,495. And that first week, we get 3 or 4. Usually we're starting our marketing in the middle of the week anyhow. So we'll let it ride an extra week, get a full week in there. The second week, we only get maybe 4 inquiries. Boom, we're going to lower that down to maybe $2,395. If we have, maybe 5 inquiries, we might just lower it $50. But if it's going to be 4 or lower, usually we're just going to drop it $100 down to $2,395. Let that sit for another week. If we're still not getting any bites to the quantity that we want, then we're going to come back and say, we need to lower it again. Price is usually the primary driver. Every once in a while, we'll find something in the ad itself that we can adjust, but usually it's price. And what this allows us to do is allows us to start high, lower it down until we find the point at which we can get enough traction to find somebody. And once we get 6 or more inquiries in a week, then we will just leave that there until we find the right tenant. We're not going to necessarily take the anybody. We want to make sure they qualify for our screening criteria. And we have another video that you'll definitely want to see about that. So hopefully that explains our how we determine it. It's a great way I've learned in my 35 years of doing this to get the most that we can without it the property going stale. So it's a best, really, in my opinion, of both worlds. Thanks very much and enjoy your day.